soldiers approaches, we salute the states and territories whose sons and daughters will graduate today.
Delaware!
Pennsylvania! New Jersey!
Georgia! Connecticut! Massachusetts!
Maryland!
South Carolina!
New Hampshire!
Virginia! New York!
North Carolina! Rhode Island! Vermont!
Kentucky! Tennessee! Ohio! Louisiana! Indiana!
Mississippi!
Illinois! Alabama! Maine! Missouri!
Arkansas! Michigan!
Florida! Texas! Iowa! Wisconsin!
California! Minnesota!
Oregon! Kansas! West Virginia! Nevada! Nebraska!
Colorado! North Dakota!
South Dakota! Montana! Washington!
Idaho!
Wyoming! Utah!
Oklahoma!
New Mexico! Arizona!
Alaska!
Can you walk out?
Hawaii! District of Columbia! Puerto Rico!
Guam!
American Samoa! Northern Mariana Islands, Virgin Islands,
state, land, order, arms. And now we invite you to join the staff of Recruit Training Command in welcoming the graduating divisions with your applause as they enter Midway Ceremonial Hall and are announced in the following order.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise as we welcome today's graduating division. Thank you.
Thank you.
908. Division 908 provides the state flag, color guard, and drumline units for today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Thank you. Divisions. Right. Face. Section leaders. Fall out and collect outer garments.
Stay. Fire. Carry. On. Forward. Platoon. Formation. Fire.
Divisions. Counter. March. May I have your attention, please? For the remainder of the review, no one will be permitted to pass in front of the review stand, and we ask this as a courtesy to our reviewing officer. Photography is certainly encouraged, but we ask that you remain seated and off the drill down. The photographers you will see on deck throughout the review are the official photographers of Recruit Training Command. Thank you. Division commanders, left or right, face, parade, rest.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'm Lieutenant Justin Lazar, Recruit Training Command's Drill Division Officer. I would like to welcome you to today's cast review. Today, you'll see 12 divisions comprised of 651 sailors participating in their graduation ceremony and soon join the most powerful Navy in the world. Please draw your attention to the unit position at center deck. There is the review commander and staff. The review commander is responsible for conducting the graduation ceremony. Today's review commander is Seaman Recruit Lillian Jarrett from San Diego, California. Let's give her a hand, folks. Performing today is the staff unit on their 6 week of training, the triple threat unit on their 7 week of training, and the state flags unit on their 8th and final week of training. These units are comprised entirely of recruits. During their night of arrival, recruits are placed into divisions of 88 personnel and assigned division commanders. Recruit division commanders form the backbone of recruit training and are key individuals in the life of every recruit. Division commanders must serve as counselors, disciplinarians, administrators, and military leaders. Above all, they must show themselves as outstanding examples of military bearing, appearance, attitude, and behavior. Each division also has a recruit chief petty officer. This senior recruit supervises the divisional staff positions and leads the division in the absence of their division commanders. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce the graduating divisions, their division commanders, and recruit chief petty officers. As I introduce each division, they will raise the competitive flags they have earned throughout their training. As I introduce each recruit chief petty officer, the flag representing their home state will also be raised. Please hold your applause until all introductions have been completed. I'll be starting from their right. Division 429, commanded by Petty Officer First Class Sean McCursey. Petty Officer Second Class John Shroom. Petty Officer Second Class Nicholas Brandt. And their recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Ryan Leffler from Lincoln, Nebraska. Division 430, commanded by Petty Officer First Class Courtney Harris. Petty Officer First Class Chantal McClellan. Petty Officer Second Class Edgar Chahone. And their recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Tiana Reeves from Decatur, Georgia. Division 431, commanded by Senior Chief Petty Officer Johan Tonneson. Petty Officer First Class Travis Stevens. Petty Officer Second Class Anthony Abraham. And their recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Evan Henry from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Division 432, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Stephen Gerner. Petty Officer First Class Adam Vasquez. Petty Officer First Class Corey Alexander. And their recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Andrew Winchell from Eura, Illinois. Division 433, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Jeffrey McCarty. Petty Officer First Class Kylie Carpenter. Petty Officer Second Class Kevin Joseph. And their recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Angelo Enclavia from Manassas, Virginia. Division 434, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Shaniqua Joyner. Petty Officer First Class Patrick Holmes. Petty Officer First Class Karen Perkins. And their recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Eliana Mullins from Casa Grande, Arizona. Division 4, 3, 5, commanded by Chief Petty Officer Derek Risch. Petty Officer First Class Adrian Modest. Petty Officer First Class John Kautz. And their recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Lennon Thorne from Bradenton, Florida. Division 4, 3, 6, commanded by Petty Officer First Class Angelo Warnock. Petty Officer First Class Luming Wong. Petty Officer First Class Rebecca Ratcliffe. And their recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Reagan Vogel from Vancouver, Washington. Division 4, 3, 7. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Christopher Slowly. Petty Officer First Class Victor Gonzalez. Petty Officer First Class Rendall Rodolfo. And their recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Thomas Whitman from Brockton, Massachusetts. Division 4, 3, 9. Commanded by Petty Officer First Class Peter Kingary. Petty Officer First Class Ethan Rutland. Petty Officer First Class Adam Toller. And their recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Kenneth Castellano from Laredo, Texas. Division 440. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Archie Sharp. Petty Officer First Class Hampton Austin. Petty Officer First Class Quincy O'Brien. And their recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Thaddeus Williams from Dallas, Texas. Division 908. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Heather Davala. Petty Officer Second Class Ariella Mitchell. Petty Officer Second Class Shellen Cumberbatch. And their recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Taylor Asher from Wichita, Kansas. On behalf of the Commanding Officer and Staff Recruit Training Command, we congratulate these Division Commanders and Recruit Chief Petty Officers on a job well done. In a moment, you'll see the ceremonial sideboys, bosun, and honor guard take their places for rival honors. This time-honored tradition is our formal greeting to this morning's reviewing officer. When requested by the announcer, please stand for the arrival honors, marching out of the colors, the national anthem, and the invocation. As a reminder, military guests shall remain covered throughout the entire graduation ceremony. And ladies and gentlemen, one final note. As befitting the importance of this occasion, our ceremony is conducted in a formal manner. However, we do encourage you to participate in today's graduation ceremony by letting your applause show these sailors just how proud of them you are. Once again, welcome aboard.
Divisions! Attack! Done!
Will the guests please rise and remain standing for the arrival of the official party? Recruit Training Command, arriving. U.S. Military Entrance Processing Command, arriving. The guests may be seated. Will the guests please rise? Present arms.
Retire the colors.
Present. Arms. Order, arms. Chaplain Brendan will offer this morning's invocation.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we join together today celebrating the accomplishments of these sailors having completed Navy recruit training. Their efforts and endurance were not in vain. They stand here today as a true source of hope and joy. We recognize these sailors pressed forward through numerous challenges and earned the honor of becoming sailors. We also recognize that there were many who were involved in helping them along the way. For the RDCs who served, investing long hours and sacrificing greatly, we ask that you refresh them. For the other staff and instructors here at recruit training who poured out time and knowledge into these sailors, give them hope to carry on. For the many families represented here, and even at a distance, those who supported their sailors through this journey, we ask that you would bring them great joy on this day. In such challenging times, thank you for raising up individuals who have taken an oath to spread freedom and democracy around the world. Fill them with wisdom. May their integrity be resolute, strengthen their minds to learn new lessons and skills. May they exercise the courage to do right in the face of adversity. May they be ever dedicated to their shipmates and families. Deepen their commitment to the Navy and the United States of America. In your name we pray. Amen.
Commanding officer would issue orders and instructions to the unit commanders. Then, the unit commanders would face about and relay the information to their divisions. Today's events show how orders are passed through the chain of command.
Divisions, report!
Very well.
graduating divisions. Request permission to commence the review.
Very well, commence the review.
Aye, sir.
Sound off!
Award winners, left or right, face. Award winners reporting, sir.
Good morning. I'm Captain Jeff Stanton, Commanding Officer of Recruit Training Command. I'm pleased to welcome families and friends to our graduation ceremony and look forward to sharing this momentous occasion with everyone. Also with us today is our reviewing officer, Colonel Megan B. Stallings, Commander, U.S. Military Entrance Processing Command. While we are restricted on occupancy, it is important you are here to celebrate your sailor's significant milestone. Your support during these unprecedented times has helped us to complete the mission of transforming civilians into sailors while operating in a safe environment to help ensure fleet readiness. I cannot thank you enough for your continued support, and I'm sure your sailors are grateful for your encouragement throughout their training. I would also like to welcome all the veterans in our audience for the service of our country. Would all veterans please stand so we can give them a round of applause? Division 908 graduates today. They are the State Flags Unit, providing the 50 state flags, District of Columbia, and U.S. Territory flags, Drum Corps, and Color Guard. Please join me in giving them a round of applause for their outstanding performances. This is where our Navy heritage meets the future, and where these young men and women enter the profession of arms. The staff of Recruit Training Command are dedicated to providing the United States Navy with basically trained, physically fit, and smartly disciplined sailors, such as those standing here this morning. These sailors have successfully completed 8 weeks of demanding recruit training. They have recently demonstrated their knowledge and their courage during battle stations, Recruit Training Command's capstone event. They have earned the right to wear a uniform recognized throughout the world as a symbol of freedom. They and others like them serve as the bedrock of our naval forces. They will join other sailors around the fleet to give our Navy its combat edge and enable us to help keep this nation secure. This training group is ready to graduate and serve in the world's most powerful Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you 651 of the newest and sharpest sailors in the United States Navy.
Promotes teamwork, attention to detail, and pride in accomplishment. Divisions performing above standards throughout their training are awarded recognition flags in 5 mission areas: academic achievement, military drill, compartment readiness, applications, and physical fitness. These flags are carried as a visible symbol of the division's success. Each flag indicates that your sailors, individually and as teams, met performance standards in 1 or more mission areas. A division that excels in every phase of training qualifies for Battle Efficiency Honor Division recognition and is awarded the Battle Honor Flag for this exemplary achievement. Division 440 has earned this honor today, and we congratulate them on a job exceptionally well done. Colonel Stallings will now present this week's individual awards, and she will be joined on the drill deck by our commanding officer, Captain Sandy. For achieving the highest overall academic score during recruit training, Airman Apprentice Fernando Alvarez, Division 433, from Yuma, Arizona, has earned the Academic Excellence Award, which is sponsored by the Late Defiance Chapter of the Illinois Society of the Sons of the American Revolution. Airman Apprentice Alvarez receives a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Extraordinary qualities best expressed in the American spirit of honor, initiative, and loyalty, Seaman Angelo Eklava, Division 433, from Manassas, Virginia, is awarded the Navy League Award, which is sponsored by the Navy League of the United States. Seaman Eklava is presented with a commemorative plaque and a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Marina Maggi, Division 908, from Denver, Colorado, is the winner of the United Service Organization Award for best exemplifying the spirit and intent of the word shipmate. Airman Maggi is given a commemorative plaque from the United Service Organization. Well done, sailor. Airman Rachel Jorgensen, Division 908 from Denver, Colorado, is the recipient of the Military Order of the World Wars Award of Merit. This award is presented for meritorious performance during recruit training. Airman Jorgensen is presented with a commemorative plaque from the Military Order of the World Wars. Well done, sailor. The Military Officers Association Leadership Award is presented to Airman Apprentice Sierra Riojas, Division 908, from Dallas, Texas, for demonstrating exceptional tenacity and professionalism. Airman Riojas is awarded a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Seaman Antonella Chavez Garcia, Division 430 from Antioch, California, is the recipient of the Navy Club of the United States of America Military Excellence Award for best exemplifying the qualities of enthusiasm, devotion to duty, military bearing, and teamwork. This award places her at the pinnacle of today's newest sailors. She is awarded a flag letter of commendation. Seaman Chavez Garcia, the staff of Recruit Training Command salutes you as the finest of this group of graduates. Well done, sailor. It is appropriate to recognize such outstanding individual accomplishments by these sailors with a round of three cheers. The adjutant will lead all graduating divisions in three cheers for this morning's award winners.
I have the distinct pleasure this morning of introducing our reviewing officer, Colonel Megan B. Stallings, Commander of U.S. Military Entrance Processing Command. She earned her commission into the Adjutant General's Corps through the United States Military Academy at West Point, New York in 1995. Among her duties, she has served as Chief Enlisted Accessions Directorate of Military Personnel Management, Headquarters Department of the Army, Human Resources Officer, Joint Force Headquarters, National Capital Region, and Military District of Washington, Fort McNair, Washington, D.C., and Commander, Marketing and Engagement Brigade, U.S. Army Recruiting Command, Fort Knox, Kentucky. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a warm Recruit Training Command welcome to Colonel Megan Stallings.
So good morning, family members, friends, and sailors. Before I get started, I'd like to give another great round of applause to those other folks supporting the ceremony today, the band, the choir, and the drill team that just performed in front of you. An amazing job. As Captain Sandy said, I'm Colonel Megan Stallings, Commander of the United States Military Entrance Processing Command. I'm honored to join you today as we congratulate these brave men and women in front of us. Your sailors have made an excellent choice by enlisting in the world's finest Navy, and many exciting opportunities wait for them. Embracing a new way of life doesn't come easy. It takes great courage to leave home and join a cause greater than yourself. I know the brave soldiers, excuse me, I'm in the Army, sailors. The brave sailors before me hold on to their values of honor, courage, and commitment. They will excel wherever the seas take them. Friends and family, you can rest assured that the Navy, and indeed the larger military community, will take care of your loved ones every step of the way. Your sailor's military journey truly began when he or she took the oath of enlistment at your local MEPS, where they pledged to defend our nation and walk through freedom's front door. As the U.S. MEPCOM commander, I know just how important the support of family and friends is to our service members. I want to personally thank each of you for attending today's ceremony, whether in person or virtually, and welcome you to our Armed Forces family. I also want to acknowledge the Recruit Training Division commanders, instructors, and staff who work so hard to turn these recruits into sailors. It's not an easy task and takes long hours and numerous sacrifices. Let's give a round of applause for the excellent staff here at Great Lakes. Boot camp is just one of the many steps that ensures our military members are prepared for the exciting tasks ahead of them, and encouragement from family and friends helps them as they move forward. From here, a sailor's journey continues as they head out to A school. In A school, they will receive training in their selective rating. Then they will join the fleet and have opportunities to travel all over the world. Sailors, your journey may have begun at the MEPS many months ago, but there are no limits to where your naval career will take you. When you took that oath to serve in the United States military, you began a career of boundless adventure and possibilities. Our forces, from the Navy, to the Army, to the Air Force, Marines, are united in ensuring our nation's security. We are one team with one mission, and I am proud to serve alongside you. On, above, or below the water, sailors are an indispensable component of the joint force. Now, more than ever, the Navy needs innovative and skilled sailors just like you. You are our future. Never lose the resiliency and strength you have shown these past 2 months at RTC. There will be challenging times ahead, but you will build friendships and memories that last forever. Congratulations, sailors, and best of luck.
Thank you.
Admiral Stallings will now receive the salute from the graduating divisions, and she will be joined on the drill deck by Commanding Officer Captain Sandin. Please remain seated until the conclusion of our ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in one more round of appreciation for our wonderful musicians of Navy Band Great Lakes. Flags. Post. Section leaders, fall out and retrieve outer garments. Thanks again to each and every one of you for joining us on this most memorable of Navy days.